box is extremely rusty. I won't be able to open it easily. It wasn't there a second ago. Officer Russell?
Officer Russell here. June 17th, 1987, 5:27 a.m. I am now entering Madison Hill's basement.
Hill? 1987?
I can see there's a sort of well in the center of the room. Looks like it's open. I'm gonna investigate further, see what's on the other side of this. Madison? Is that you? Please! Show yourself! That's an order! Don't come in any closer!
So this fucking camera belonged to that woman. Why is this happening to me? I gotta get the hell out of... Thank you.
damn. My head. It hurts. The attic. I don't understand. My head.
The 43-year-old woman was killed by a police officer.
What a mess. The entrance key should be somewhere.
Grandma's diary?
What are these things? There are meds everywhere. That song. It's open now. There's definitely someone here. These photos are pretty old. Grandpa never got over her death.
Grandpa's office. How to contact the dead? All this time, we thought he went mad. He only wanted to talk to her again.
So Grandpa tried to contact Grandma with this thing? Is that blood?
Becoming possessed by a wicked entity is signified by a loss of control over the body, mind, and the soul. However, that is often not enough for the entity. It hungers for more. Things get much worse for the host. In these cases, possession is just the first step of the demon's plan. It is said there are those that return to our world seeking to resolve unfinished matters from their mortal lives. Victims of these wicked possessions are subjected to a departure of sorts. An astral transportation, for lack of a better word.
An astral what?
These malicious beings force their hosts to live moments that shouldn't be possible in a different place and time, perhaps even in a different dimension altogether. It's madness. It's unclear whether these transportations occur inside the mind, or if the host is physically taken to some alternative reality.
Alternative reality? I'm losing my mind.